This video goes with section 37 of Hansen and Quinn's Greek and Intensive course and covers the first declension nouns in short alpha and masculine first declension nouns that end in ace or os. Hansen and Quinn has this on pages 87 and 89 and in the appendix pages 622 to 624. You already know the first declension endings in eta and long alpha. You learn to get the stem of the noun in a Greek first declension. You go to the genitive, that second word, and take off the ace or the os. And then you add endings to those stems. Here's a reminder of them. Greek also has a number of first declension nouns that end in short alpha in the nominative, and you need to learn slightly different endings for those. We'll make a chart for singular and plural and all the cases. For these nouns, the nominative and vocative will be the same, so I'm combining. Here are the endings for the first declension with nominatives in short alpha. A, ace, a, on. The plural, as promised when you first learned first declension, is the same for all the varieties of first declension. I own, ice, os. They have persistent accent and still have the first declension exception. All genitive plurals have a circumflex over the omega of the ending. Now you need the endings for the first declension with nominatives in short alpha, but whose stems end in epsilon, iota, or rho. As you've seen, Attic Greek doesn't like to say an eta after those letters, so there's some adjustment. A, os, a, on. You can see the etas in the genitive and dative become long alphas. Whether the alphas are long and short matter to accent, of course, but otherwise you just need to remember when you need to use an alpha or an eta, and that will be part of memorizing your vocabulary or noticing that the stem ends in an epsilon, an iota, or a rho. Notice that the genitive singular and accusative plural are the same. Watch your context to translate. Now, most of these endings you already know from what you originally learned in the first declension. And it's just the nominative, accusative, and vocative that are different with short alphas. So let's put these things together for the nouns thalata and musa. First, we need our stems, and so we take the genitive, remove the endings, and there we have our stems. Now we need endings, which are here as a reminder. Here's a chart, and we add the stem to all of the cases and numbers, and then we add the endings. A, ace, a, on. I own, ice, us. Then we need to add the accents according to persistent rules. So nominative singular, because the persistent accent here wants to be an acute on the first syllable, we get to keep it that way because that last syllable is short. In the genitive singular, the last syllable becomes long, and so it pulls the acute to the second to last syllable. Same thing in the dative, but when we get to the accusative, that last alpha is short again, and so it can go back to the third to last syllable, tha, the way it wants to. Again, in the nominative plural, because alpha iota at the end of a word is short, the persistent accent gets to stay at the beginning. But own follows that exception to all persistent accent rules and has the circumflex over the ending. The last syllable is long in the dative plural, so the acute is pulled to second to last, and the last syllable, that alpha, is also long in the accusative plural, and so the acute has to be on the second to last. Now let's do musa. Here are the stems all laid out for us, and here are the endings. A, ace, a, on, I, own, ice, os. Persistent accent, which is given by the nominative singular of the noun, and you learn that as part of your vocabulary. So this time it wants to be a circumflex on the second to last syllable, which works, of course, because we have a short alpha at the end. But in the genitive singular, it changes to a long eta, and so it has to switch to an acute. In persistent accent, an accent will change which kind it is before it moves, if it can. So we get an acute again in the dative singular because of the long ending, but the last syllable goes back to short in the accusative singular, and so we can do a circumflex, which is the way it wants to be. Same in the nominative plural, because alpha iota counts as short, so musai. Then we have our big exception, first declension exception, with the circumflex over the ending. And then our last two cases and numbers, dative and accusative plural, have long last syllables, and so although the accent can stay on the second to last syllable, it has to be an acute. Now, let's look at Gephura and Moira, bridge and fate, whose stems end in rho, and so we're going to have to shift our etas to long alphas. Here's the chart of endings and our chart to put our word in, and here's our stem, and here are the endings. Os, ah, on, I, own, ice, os. Persistent accent tries to be an acute over the third to last syllable, but it moves around in the ways that we've talked about with the other words as the last syllable changes its quantity. Notice again that genitive singular and accusative plural can be mistaken for each other, and you have to check your context to decide which one it is. Now for Moira, here are the stems all laid out, and add the endings, ah, us, ah, on, I, own, ice, us, persistent accent, and the accents trying to stay a circumflex on the moi in the Moira, but it has to shift around according to what the last syllable's quantity is. Again, notice that the genitive singular and the accusative plural look the same, so you'll have to check your context. So far, all the first declension nouns you have had have been feminine. There's a subsection of the first declension, though, that has masculine nouns. They tend to be agent nouns for doers of things, kind of the way you can add er to do to make a person who is a noun doer, or er to sing to make a singer. In the same way, Greek can make doer nouns with ais or os endings in the nominative and ou genitive singulars. So let's learn their endings. Nominative and genitive, you'll know from the vocabulary, and the genitives in this subsection of the first declension show off their masculinity with ou, but they're still first declension. The rest should be familiar. A, ain, a or a in the vocative, and then the plural, as promised, just the same as all of the first declension. It has persistent accent, with the same exception in the genitive plural. Now, when the stem ends in epsilon, iota, or rho, the eta endings become alpha endings. And you've seen that happen many times before, so it should start to be familiar. So the strangest part here is the genitive singular, which doesn't look like first declension at all. And you'll just have to learn as part of your vocabulary that these nouns behave in the first declension and learn this pattern for their endings. Your first three nouns like this are polites, citizen, poietes, poet, and neanias, young man. You'll recognize these, as I say, as first declension masculines by seeing that nominative paired with the genitive u. So that ace u pattern or os u pattern clues you in. To get the stem, we take the genitive and take off the u. And then we're going to need endings. Here they are to remind you. And here's the chart. And let's start with the stems for polites. Here are the singular endings. Ace, oo, ain, a, ain, a. And our familiar plural ones. I, own, ice, us, I. Persistent accent. And that goes in like this, just as you would expect. The words with the circumflexes, that is to say, the vocative singular, the nominative and vocative plural, are that way by the circumflex rule. The accent wants to be on the second to last syllable, because the persistent accent rule means we look at the nominative singular to decide where the accent wants to stay. But the iota is long, and the last syllable in those forms is short, so it has to be a circumflex. Now let's look at poietes. Here are the stems, and let's add the endings. Ace, oo, a, ain, a, ice, own, ice, I, us, I. Persistent accents, which go on this way. In the genitive and dative, if it's persistent accent on the ultima, it changes from acute to circumflex, something that you're also used to seeing by now. And then just one more to show you the alpha after iota rather than eta after iota endings. Nea nias, young man. With the stems all in place, let's put on the endings. As, u, a, on, a. I, own, ice, us, I. Persistent accent, which this time looks like this, and they can all stay quite happily over the iota in the second to last syllable, except for the exception of the first declension genitive plural ending, which always gets that circumflex over the omega. In this instance, that iota is short, and so the circumflex rule doesn't come into play in the vocative singular or the nominative and vocative plural. That's what you need to know about these new varieties of the first declension, and you should be able to put that into practice in drills, in class, and in translation.